Yeah, good morning, everyone. US market saw more of a sideways movement on Friday and ended flattish. And even today morning, US markets are not indicating any great direction. We should be watchful that last 8 days, US market has consistently improved and reached to all-time high. So one need to be careful. There could be some profit booking in the US market, which may have some impact on the other Asian and international market as well. Apart from that, Asian markets are mixed. Japan is showing positive sign. Japan is showing negative sign, whereas the other market are a bit positive. Whereas in commodity, also there are oil again moving above $86, and it was in the range of $84 and $86, and today it is indicating that it is moving out. And similar to that, even the gas prices, that is natural gas prices, which was correcting from 650 to almost around 450 and then showing bounce back, is up by, was up by around 5% on Friday in the US market. So energy over there again showing some sign of positiveness. So one need to be watchful in that. In natural gas, we had earlier also said that Hindustan Oil HOEC, which got corrected with the correction in the natural gas prices from around over to 210 level to now around 170, 180 level, can see some bounce back with the natural gas prices moving up. Apart from that, aluminium was down by 1%, copper was flat in the today's morning, and iron ore was up by around 4%, and steel was up by around 1%. If you see the soft commodity over there, like thermal coal, menthol oil, methanol, PVC, which were declining since last 5-6 days consistently, are still showing a lower sign only and are reaching to the euphoria area, which started a few months back. Like coal in the China moved up from $200 to $300, and now it is back to around $220. So all these are coming back to their origin, and looks like they will settle at the origin level only. Now I'll request technical team to take up from here.
Yes, thank you, sir. Good morning, all of you. This is Swati Hotkar. Last week, we have seen that Nifty from the last 4 days, continuously we are witnessing a selling pressure on the Nifty. From 18,600 onwards, we have seen a fall into the Nifty towards 18,040 levels. Now going ahead, 18,000 will act as a psychological support level. If it's break that level, then we are going to witness a more selling pressure into the market, which might take a Nifty towards 17,800 to 17,700 levels. On a contrary basis, last week, we have seen that the Bank Nifty has maintained a very positive closing, up by almost 2.5%. We have not yet seen any selling pressure into the Bank Nifty side. If the Bank Nifty started started a selling pressure into the Bank Nifty, then again we are going to get a hit into the Nifty as well. On coming towards the Nifty for an intraday purpose, 18,000 will act as an important first support level. If it's break that level, then we are going to witness a fall which might take a Nifty downward towards 17,800 to 17,700. Whereas on higher side, 18,200 will act as an immediate resistance level. Any move about that level, then we are going to witness some pullback rally, which might take a Nifty towards 18,300 to 18,400 levels. So it's a little bit cautious view on the Nifty. As long as it trades above 18,000 psychological mark, the view will remain a positive. But those who are having any long positions, they should maintain, but with the strict stop losses, because in the coming week, we are going to witness selling pressure if we are getting a hit from the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty as of now is well placed above its 40,000 mark. Even we have seen that the last week it has been maintained a positive closing by 2.5% on the higher side. Now for the today intraday purpose, it has a crucial support level of 40,200 on a downside. If it's break that level, then we are going to witness a selling pressure into the Bank Nifty as well, which might take a Bank Nifty towards 40,000 on lower end. below that level, 39,800 will be likely seen. On the higher side, 40,500 will be the immediate resistance level. Any move above that level, we expect the rally is likely to be continued towards 40,700 to 40,900 on the higher sides. The overall view on the Bank Nifty will remain a positive as long as it sustains above 40,000 levels. On the Nifty Finance side, we are continuously witnessing a positive momentum into this particular indices. As of now, if we look towards the RSI, then it's just entering into the overbought zone. So probably we might see some selling pressure coming into the Nifty Finance as well. For the today intraday purpose, the support is placed at 18,900 levels. Below that level, we are going to witness some profit booking, which might take a Nifty Finance towards 18,700 to 18,600 levels. Whereas on the higher side, 19,200 will be the immediate resistance zone. Above that level, 19,300 and 19,400 levels can be seen. So the overall view on the Nifty will remain a cautious. Nifty, Bank Nifty, and both the three indices will be remain cautious. Long positions can be hold on, but with the strict stop losses. Stock specific, we can see that the bankings are really performing very well in the last week. So as I said, the Bank Nifty has outperformed the Nifty. So one can go for a longs into the banking stocks, such as the Federal Bank looks really good, Axis Bank really looks good. So these are the two counters which are looking a positive, on the banking front. On the auto pack, TVS Motor really looks very good. So during a day, we might initiate a long position into those counters. I think that's it from my end. I request derivative guys to take a call forward.
Yeah, thank you, Swati. On the derivative front, see, majorly the data remains the same. The two things to note. The VIX, as we have been saying from the last few days, in fact, more than a month, the VIX continues to remain high, and that is one cause of worry. 17 and a half is a high level for the VIX. So unless that comes down, we might see that pain still being there. Also, very important to note is the pain is not on the index level. The pain is on actually the stock level. So, difficult to say what levels the index can probably come down to, but there is definitely pain. And that is what has happened sometime back as well, when the VIX had gone high, the stocks had corrected, but the index had not corrected as much. So probably you might see on an index level, 18,000 being a strong support area, highest put base also at this level. Very likely, 18,000 would be not broken going forward. We might, see a retest of 18,000 odd levels, but probably not go below the same. But the stocks can correct 5 to 10% if the VIX continues to remain high. The second thing to note here is the PCR OI. This has come down to 0.8 odd levels. Again, 0.8 and below, the oversold zone starts for this particular index. And that is why we believe, further if the PCR OI declines, that means it is in oversold zone, and very likely we might see a bounce coming in the next 1 or 2 days, which is a good sign. So, along with PCR OI, if the VIX decreases considerably, then it is a sign where one can know that, some amount of buying will come in back into the market. So look out for the same. From the stock specific front, banking has been doing pretty well, as Swati mentioned as well. From the banking front, we believe Axis Bank is poised to witness a good growth in terms of price. It can go up towards the 850, 860 odd level. So one can look to buy with a stop loss of 800. Federal Bank has added a good open interest built up. It has broken out as well. So this stock can be bought as well.
Also, the PSUs have been consolidating in the last few trading sessions, but they are likely to make a comeback. And the best pick at this point of time seems to be ONGC and Coal India. So look out for these two stocks as well. They are likely to move up again. That's it from my side. I'd like to ask the fundamental team to take over, please.
Good morning. We also agree with what the technical and derivatives analysts have said about the banking sector. So whatever results that are coming are above expectations, and the trend is of that of acceleration of growth. So firstly, ICICI Bank result was above expectation. NIMs were at 4% all-time high levels. They have been continuously increasing by almost 10 basis points since last many quarters. Domestic loan growth was at 19% year-on-year, which is at a 7-year high. And the bank has made enough contingent provisions to take care of any future slippages from restructured book or the BB and below book. So future credit cost is expected to keep coming down. Bank is already at 14% ROE, and we expect over next 4-5 quarters, this can inch up to around 16%, which is where HDFC Bank is. So on the other hand, the valuation is at 2.2 times FY23 book value. And we feel that over next 1 year, this could inch closer to 3 times. And stock can head towards a target of around 1,000 rupees in 1 year's time. Federal Bank result was also above expectation. Slippage ratio dipped to just 1%, which is one of the lowest in the banking industry. However, restructured book has increased from 1.9 to 2.6%. This phenomena we have seen in almost all banks, that the restructured book is rising. But on other hand, again, they are making some provision on the restructured book as well. And so that future, we don't see this as a major concern. And future credit cost in case of Federal also should keep coming down. Management has guided to increase ROA from 0.9% in current quarter to 1% by Q4 of this year. So in next two couple of quarters, and to 1.2% by FY24. So if they were to deliver, then there is a good scope for appreciation in the stock. HDFC Life Insurance result was marginally above expectation. We have seen that on monthly number basis, it has been underperforming in recent months. APE grew by 19% year-on-year, less than industry growth. VNB margins have been maintained at 26% for many quarters now, which is good. We think company can deliver stable 20% odd compounding from these levels. We are positive. Yes Bank result was in line with estimates, although even gross stressed book has come down from 34% last quarter to 29%, but even 29 the quantum remains very high. So expect that credit cost will remain high for next few quarters as well. So we are neutral over here. Steel Strips Wheels and Auto Ancillary Company, which makes steel wheels, result was in line. Revenue growth was more than 100%. Revenues were at 958 odd crores. EBITDA margin increased to 14% versus historical levels of 10 to 12%. So this is the second quarter where EBITDA margin has been above the 14% mark. And we expect margins to further improve because of operating leverage and product mix shift towards high margin products of alloy wheels and exports. So we are positive over here. MCX result was below expectation on all fronts. Revenue declined 5% quarter on quarter and 30% year on year. Even profits came at just 33 crores against a June quarter profit of 41 crores and year ago period 59 crores. So main reason is that gold and silver both have been declining and both contribute to almost 50% of their volumes. On other hand, oil and gas both have been moving up, but their contribution to revenues is lower. So we will, for the stock to perform, we will need that all four commodities actually go up from here. Currently we are neutral. That's it from my side. Thank you. Akansha or Avisha, anyone has...
Good morning, everyone. Tata Elxsi has posted improved set of numbers for the quarter, both on the revenue and the margin front. Constant currency revenue grew by 7.4% QoQ and EBITDA margins came in at 30.8% versus QoQ of 26.9%. Share is trading at 81.8 times GTM EPS. TCI Express has posted in line with expectation set of numbers for the quarter. Share is trading at 37 times FY23 EPS. Coforge has posted broadly in line with expectation set of numbers, but as compared to peer company growth, Coforge growth is lower. Order intake came in at $285 million and dollar revenue came in at $212.8 million versus expectation of $212 million. EBITDA margins came in at 17.5% versus expectation of 17.3%. Share is trading at 37.9 times FY23 EPS. Thank you.
Yeah, good morning. Hindustan Zinc result was in line with expectation. The EBITDA margin came at 54.5% versus expectation of 55.5% quarter on quarter. The management has reiterated its guidance on volume and capex for FY22. Both mined metal and finished metal production for FY22 is expected to be between 1025 to 1050 kiloton each. The capex for FY22 is expected to be around $100 million. In the previous quarter, the management had cautioned against risk to cost guidance from rising input commodity prices. And the management has indicated a rise of $50 per ton for the next quarter. The management is facing some delay in commissioning of its Fuma plant due to the stringent visa guidelines for Chinese nationals, which continued during the quarter. Earlier, the guidance of commissioning was in Q3 FY22, but now they have changed by the end of FY22. The share is trading at EBITDA of 7.69 times FY23. Kirloskar Ferrous Industries result has declined on both revenue and EBITDA front. The share is trading at EV by EBITDA of 5.98 times FY23 EBITDA. Thank you.
Yeah, a few more results. First of all, Reliance Industry has reported very good numbers. Mainly driven by two things. One is O2C business has come up very strongly. And apart from that, even retail business has shown good growth. O2C business has reported excellent revenue well ahead of expectations of around 10,000 crores to the company reported around 12,000 crores. And this was the key driver. EBITDA margin remained stable quarter on quarter and year on year in this particular quarter. And similarly, Reliance Retail also had shown good growth of almost 19% quarter on quarter and 9% year on year. And EBITDA margin has also shown substantial improvement of around 7.3% quarter on quarter, 5.8% and year on year, 5.5%. Whereas the Jio performance was mixed, wherein they had cleaned up the subscriber base and as such subscriber base has reduced by 11.1 million. Seems like lower end of subscriber has come down and as such the ARPU has increased from 138 to 143.5 rupees. Apart from that, the result was more of if you see the revenue and all are showing steady growth of around 4.4% quarter on quarter, and EBITDA margin has also shown improvement quarter on quarter by 100 pips, above 10 pips. So overall result was ahead of expectation, mainly driven by O2C and retail business. Outlook all depend on see the volume has come up and the stock has also run up ahead of the results in last 15-20 days. So and the valuations are also comparatively fairly priced. So any good corrections can be used to buy this stock rather than at the current price. Apart from that, the results in last 2 days which has come, that is Friday evening, Saturday, the key results which need to be watched are in smaller companies are Vimta Lab. One can look at this company. This company has come up with good results. Then Tattva Chintan has also come up with good result, and Kajaria Ceramic has come up with the good results. Apart from that, at Vardhman Acrylic, though the result was subdued, but company has declared dividend of rupees 25. It's a small company trading at around 70 rupees, but the company has declared dividend of rupees 25. So one can look at that also. Apart from that, results on 27th, 27th we have Arvind Limited results. Here they got they are in all value chain of textile, yarn, fabric, and even garments. So yarn, we had seen the companies are reporting flattish result quarter on quarter, whereas fabric and fabrics are showing declining results. So overall result likely to be declining. Bajaj Auto results are likely to be okay. We already know the volume that has grown by around 8.6% year on year. Here the margins, though year on year will decline, but quarter on quarter will see some improvement from 15.1 to 16%. So results are, but still will be remaining lower than their normal level of margin of around 17%. So results are likely to be okay. Balaji Amines results seems to be declining quarter on quarter. Last quarter they reported EBITDA of around 32%. Here the expectation is around 26.5%. So results are likely to decline. We are already seeing last 4-5 days the prices are correcting. Cummins India results are likely to show improvement. Year on year revenue growth around 15% and EBITDA growth of around 14%. Dalmia Bharat results seems to be more in line. EBITDA per ton quarter on quarter decline of around 260 rupees. We had seen that the southern companies are showing decline of around 250 rupees, and even for Dalmia Bharat it is expected at around 260 rupees. So it seems look like more of in line. Deepak Nitrite results are likely to be more of a flattish results quarter on quarter. Last quarter EBITDA margin was 30%. Here this quarter it is expected at around 29%, and even revenue quarter on quarter are expected to come off by around 3%. So results are likely to be more of a flattish quarter on quarter. Then ITC is likely to report number, and here the numbers are likely to be more of a flattish. Revenue likely to grow by around 8% year on year, and EBITDA is likely to grow by around 4% quarter year on year. JK Papers, we are seeing most of the papers company are showing good results. So JK Paper can report a better number in this quarter. KPR Mill, which is mainly in yarn and then fabric and garment, yarn contribution is comparatively higher. As such, results are likely to show flattish improvement in KPR Mill results. KEI Industry, we had seen that the Polycab and Havells both had seen decline in their margin, though the revenue growth was good for cable division. For both these company, and KEI is more of a peer to them, and similar case is expected for KEI Industry also. Revenue is likely to show good improvement year on year of around 20-25%, whereas EBITDA margins is likely to come under pressure. Then L&T is likely to report numbers. Numbers are likely to be more of a okay, stable type of numbers. Order booking is expected at around 40,000 crores. Revenue growth is expected at around 8% year on year, and margins are also likely to remain stable. So more of a flattish type of number for Larsen & Toubro. Lupin is again, last quarter we had seen extraordinary margins because of some one-off in that quarter. But apart from that, if we see the year-on-year number, it looks like more of a flattish type of number. Revenue likely to grow by around 4% and margins is likely to expand by around 100 pips year-on-year, but will not be able to reach to their steady state margin of around 18%. This quarter margin expected it around 16%. Then Mahindra Logistics is likely to show better number, improved number, and Maruti Suzuki numbers are likely to be more of a, again, we know the volume figure and the volumes are likely to show a decline year on year by around 4%. And margins year on year are likely to decline by around 300 pips, though quarter on quarter it will show improvement. So more of a results will be declining. Then PSP project is likely to show improved set of number. Revenues is likely to grow by around 50% plus and the EBITDA margin is also likely to expand. So result is likely to be good. Sagar Cement is likely to report number. Here, quarter on quarter, EBITDA per ton is likely to decline by around 220 rupees, whereas Dalmia Bharat, we had seen it is 260, another company 250. So it's comparatively better for Sagar Cement. Then Tata Chemical is likely to report number. Quarter on quarter numbers are likely to be more of a okay. Rallis India, which is a subsidiary of Tata Chemical, has already shown declining number. Apart from that, quarter on quarter margins are likely to come up by around 100-150 pips. Titan, we had already seen that they had reported revenue growth, substantial revenue growth in this quarter, both in jewelry, watches, all the divisions. And the margins are also expected to improve substantially and come to their normal level of margins. So results are likely to show good improvement. We had already seen the result. Company has already performed in recent past. Torrent Power is again likely to show more of a steady growth. Result is likely to show improvement. Revenue growth of around 10% year on year and margin to expand by 100-150 basis points. Then Tube Investment is also likely to show improvement and even United Breweries is likely to show good improvement year on year because of the lower base. United Spirit is also likely to show good improvement in this quarter, whereas Wellspun India is likely to show more of a flattish number, though Trident, we had seen that Trident has reported very good number, but Wellspun expectation is that the numbers will be more of a flattish in this quarter. So that's all from us. Thank you very much and have a good day.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel for in-depth interviews of India Inc. and press the bell icon so that you do not miss our updates.